हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर लर्निंग फिफ्थ चैप्टर एक्सरसाइज नंबर 5.5। एज वी सीन इन अर्लियर क्लास 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, 5.4, नाउ टुडे वी आर सीन 5.5। द 5.5 ऑफ फिफ्थ लेसन अंडरस्टैंडिंग एलिमेंट्री शेप्स, दिस इज द फिफ्थ चैप्टर। इन दैट वी विल नाउ सी 5.5, प्लीज पे अटेंशन। Exercise number 5.5. The first question. The first question. Which of the following are model of perpendicular lines? Now we are seeing the lines, perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines means what? The line which one line straight and another line cuts that straight line in a straight. That is called perpendicular lines. Like a plus sign. Plus sign, so that is a perpendicular line. So the adjacent edges of a tabletop, if you see the tabletop, we will take example of this duster. We will assume this is one line and this is one line, this line and this line, they both are perpendicular, top edge line, so perpendicular. So the adjacent edges, this is an edge and this is edge. When both the edges are meeting, so this L-shaped figure, T-shaped figures, if it's form a L or it form a T, so that lines are perpendicular lines. So first one is perpendicular line. The line of a railway track. Now if you see the railway track, it is not a perpendicular. Why? Because railway tracks are parallel. One opposite another, they are going parallel, straight lines, both lines are straight. So that lines are not a perpendicular lines. The line segment forming the letter L. So it is a L, so perpendicular line. One line straight and another line cut from the down. So that is a perpendicular lines. The letter V. V is not a perpendicular, not a parallel. So it is not a perpendicular line. Now next question we will see. Now this is question number 2. Let PQ be the perpendicular to the segment XY and PQ. Segment XY. Let PQ and XY intersect in the point A. What is the measure of angle PAY? Now this is PQ line and this is XY line. They both are straight lines connecting here. So this line is a perpendicular to each other. So you can say PA is a perpendicular to XY. And you can say AQ is a perpendicular to XY, and also you can say AY is perpendicular to PQ, and also you can say AX is a perpendicular to PQ. So he is asking what is the measurement of PAQ. Whenever perpendicular lines are there, so the angle formed is right angle. Right angle means 90 degree. So here is right angle 90 degree. Here also forming a right angle 90. Here also 90. Here also 90. So measure angle PAY is equal to how much? 90. So that is a 90. Now question number 3. The question number 3 is, there are two set squares in your compass box. What are the measure of the angle that are formed at their corners? Do they have any angle measure that is a common? If you see a set square in your compass box, you know set squares, the triangle shape instruments which are in a compass box, So if you see first set square, it is 45 degree, 90 degree, 45 degree, one set square, where both two angles are equal, 45, 45, and the next one is 90 degree. If you see the another set square, that is 30 degree, 90 degree, and 60 degree. We have a two set square. That both are in a right angle. So both are in a right angle shape. First one is 45, 45, 90. Third one is 36 and 90. These are the measurement of that set squares. Now next question. And the common is what? 90 degrees. The common angle is what? 90 degrees. As here they are asking what is common. So common is a 90 degree. Question number 4. Study the diagram. This is the diagram. The line M. This is the line M. Is perpendicular to line M. And this is the line M. They both are perpendicular. Because one line is going straight in perpendicular, one is going in horizontal, one is in vertical. So they are forming a 90 degrees here. And he is asking if CE is equal to EG. If you see CE, this 2, the difference between CE is 2 points and EG. And EG, the difference between is 2 points. So they are equal. Yes, both measure 2 units. Both measure 2 units. Distance between CE is 2 units and EG is 2 units. So they both are equal. This is equal. Yes, they both are measurement are equal. Now next, does PE bisect CG? Now if you see PE, this is PE and bisect CG. Bisect CG. Bisect means what? Accurate cut from the middle. A line which cut from the middle, that is called the bisecting lines. So yes, because CE is equal to again EG, this PE accurately cutting the CG line into two parts, equal two parts, here 2 points and here 2 points. Yes, because CE is equal to EG, bisect means cutting equally. And he is asking only C to G, leave this alphabet, say leave that alphabet. The alphabet is asking C and G. This if you cut PE equally 2 units and 2 units. So that is called bisect. Now, identify any two line segment for which PE is the perpendicular bisector. So we have to find out PE is the perpendicular bisect. So you can see D and F, it is cut in the middle equally, C and G equally, and B and H equally. Distance from D to E is equal and E to H is equal. C to E is equal, E to G is equal, D to E and E to F is equal. So this PE bisect how many 3 points, which are there? BH, C, G and DF. These are the 3. So here we are given DF, CG and BH. Here is perpendicular. Next question, are these true? Here is given 3 questions, you have to say whether they are true or false. AC is greater than FG. This is a sign of greater than. If you see AC, AC 2 units and FG, FG 1 unit. So AC having 2 units and FG is 1 unit. So it is a greater? Yes. First one is a true because it is a greater. Second one, CD, CD 1 unit, GH, GH 1 unit. They both are equal. It is asking equal. Yes, they both are equal. Yes, they both are equal. True. Next. They are asking BC smaller than EH. BC 1 unit and EH 3 units. So yes, BC is smaller than EH because it is 1 unit and it is 3 units. It is true. So all these 3 are true. All these 3 are true. Now we will go to the next. Now here the next exercise, 5.6. 5.6 first question, name the type of following triangles. Now different names of triangle. If all three sides are equal of a triangle, that is called equilateral triangle. If three sides equal of a triangle, so that is equilateral triangle. If two sides are equal, so that triangle is a isosceles triangle, and three sides are different, so then that is a scalene triangle. Now we will see here triangle with length of sides 7 cm, 8 cm, 9 cm. These three sides are different. So which triangle it is? It is scalene triangle because three sides are different. So that is scalene triangle. That is scalene triangle. Once again, I am explaining you, if any triangle three sides are equal, then that triangle is a equilateral triangle. Equi means all equal parts, all equal sides. Second one, if two sides, any two sides, these two sides or these two sides are equal or these two sides are equal, then that is what? Isosceles triangle, means two sides equal. And if three sides are different, scalene triangle. So first one, 7 cm, 8 cm, 9 cm, it is what? Scalene triangle. Next, triangle ABC with AB is equal to 8.7 cm, AC is equal to 7 cm and BC is equal to 6 cm. Again, three sides are different. Again, three sides are different. So which is that? That is also spherical triangle. Again, three sides are different. Next question: triangle PQR such that PQ is equal to QR is equal to PR. All three sides are equal. That is 5 cm. So which triangle it is? Equilateral triangle. That is equilateral triangle. Third one. Next, triangle DEF with measure 90°. Now, any triangle having a 90° in that, so that is right angle triangle. In any triangle, if one angle is 90°, so that is right angle triangle. So here one angle is 90°, so that is right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. Next, triangle XYZ with measure angle Y is equal to 90. Y is equal to 90 and side XY is equal to YZ. It is right angle triangle having two sides equal. Having two sides equal and one is 90°. So it is right angle triangle, isosceles triangle. It is isosceles also, right angle also. So it is isosceles right angle triangle. Because two sides are equal, isosceles. And one angle is 90°. So isosceles right angle triangle. So isosceles right angle triangle, this one. Because one is 90° and two sides are equal. When we see that, before we see that two sides are equal, isosceles, one angle is 90. So right isosceles right angle triangle. Last one, next question, not last. Triangle LMNB measure angle L is 30°, M is 70° and L is 90°. If you see these all angles of a triangle, triangle having three sides and three angles. All the three angles are less than 90°. All the three angles are less than 90°. So that is acute angle triangle. You know acute angle means? Acute angle means angle which is less than 90°. So here the three angles are less. So it is acute angle triangle. So it is acute angle triangle. Because all the three angles are less than 90, less than 90, less than 90. So that type of triangle is acute angle triangle. Next question we will see now. Now next question is, match the following. Here is given measure of a triangle and here is given type of a triangle. Three sides equal length. Three sides equal length which comes under what? Isosceles triangle. Sorry. Three sides equal. It is what? Equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. First one is what? E. First one is what? E. Equilateral triangle, all three sides are equal. Two sides equal. Two sides equal means what? Isosceles triangle. Two sides equal means isosceles triangle. Second one is second B. Second one is second B. Two sides of equal length, that is isosceles triangle. That is B. That is isosceles triangle, sorry, it is isosceles right angle, not this one, this one. G1, isosceles triangle. This is only two sides equal and not side angle. So, isosceles triangle, second one is G. Third one, all sides are of different length. All sides different means scalene triangle. Where is the scalene triangle? A1 is a scalene triangle. All three sides are different, scalene triangle. Third one is A scalene triangle. Three acute angles. Just we have seen three acute angles. Acute angle means what? Acute angle triangle. Three acute angles means acute angle triangle. So which one? Three acute angle triangle. Where is the acute angle triangle? Acute angle triangle. Acute angles. F. Fourth one is F. One right angle. One right angle means that is right angle only. One right angle means that is right angle. That is D1. Fifth one is the right angle triangle. Next, one obtuse angle. So that is obtuse angle triangle. It is obtuse angle. C1. Next one is what? C. Next, one right angle with two equal length. So, which one? Isosceles right angle. That is isosceles right angle. Isosceles right angle. Now, next question. Now question number, name each of the following triangle in two different ways. Two different ways means, first we have to say scalene triangle or isosceles triangle or equilateral triangle, along with that scalene triangle, acute scalene triangle or acute right triangle in this. First one, all three are, two are same, one is different. So it comes under, and all three angles are acute. So acute angle triangle and isosceles triangle. Why? Isosceles two sides are equal. And all three are less than 90 means acute angle also and isosceles triangle also. Next, three sides are different. three sides are different with scalen triangle. One angle is 90. So scalen triangle and right angle. Right angle and scalen triangle. This is right angle triangle, also scalen triangle, because all three sides are different. So you can say this triangle in two different ways. One is right angle triangle and scalen angle triangle. Why right angle? Because 90 degree, and why scalen? Because all three sides are different. Next, these two sides are equal. So this is isosceles triangle. Along with the isosceles triangle, one is obtuse angle here. One angle is obtuse. Obtuse angle means obtuse angle triangle and two sides are equal, isosceles triangle. So that one is obtuse angle triangle and isosceles triangle. Next one, two sides are equal. So isosceles triangle along with one 90 degree. 90 degree means right angle. So this comes under what? Right angle triangle and isosceles triangle. Next one, three sides are equal. Three sides are equal means equilateral triangle. And three angles are less than 90. So what is the equilateral triangle and acutangle triangle? Three angles are less than 90, so acutangle triangle, and three sides are equal, so isosceles triangle. Next one, three sides are different, so scalen triangle. Three sides are different, scalen triangle, and one obtuse angle. So obtuse angle and also scalen triangle. Obtuse angle triangle and scalen triangle. Now next question we'll see now. This is the last fourth question for this exercise. Question number 4. Try to construct triangle using matchsticks. Some are shown here. Now here we prepare with the matchsticks, these triangles. So what is that? Three matchsticks. Use three matchsticks and prepare one triangle. So when you use three matchsticks, so you will get an equilateral triangle because all three sides are equal. One matchstick means same length. With four matchsticks. With four matchsticks you can prepare. How we will keep four matchsticks? So that four matchsticks, see how it will become five matchsticks, six matchsticks. Remember, you have to use all available matchsticks in each case. If you cannot make a triangle, think of reason for it. So take the matchsticks and try to prepare the triangle. Here this shown 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 matchstick is shown. And here it is shown 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 matchsticks. So in this way that is shown. If you use 4 matchsticks, so what happened? 1 matchsticks you can keep here. 3 matchsticks we cannot kept properly. So with 4 matchsticks it is very difficult for you to make a triangle. So we require minimum how many? 3 matchsticks, 5 matchsticks. In this way you can use 6 matchsticks, 2, 2, 2, equally. So today we will stop here. In this chapter we see, in this class we see two exercises. One is 5.5 and one is 5.6. Two exercises the same. If you not understand any part of this, so please repeat the video, reverse the video and see once, twice, so you will understand. Here on the board already the figures are drawn and the problem is already solved. So I explain you maybe very fast, or maybe you not understand some points. So please revise and receive that again so you can understand. Okay, bye. And please don't forget to this subscribe and like my video. Thank you very much.